form. One fearless expectation. Tonight, for the first time in nearly two decades, the Texas stage hosts a top 10 showdown. The Kansas State Wildcats, led by one of college football's most potent weapons, battle bowl staples, the Arkansas Razorbacks, who have an offense to be reckoned with all their own. The front page is blank. The history books are waiting. Failure might be humbling, but I prefer victory. The AT&T Cotton Bowl, next on Fox.
CD, bold predictions by Marcus and Moose, but you understand why. Nobody expected K-State to go this far this season, but because of Bill Snyder and the philosophy of toughness that he's established, this team can play with anybody.
Toughness, which leads to power, especially on offense and how they run the football. You heard the guys talk about Colin Klein and what he would provide from the quarterback position in the run game. Well, the offensive line, a bunch of maulers, tough guys who will chop holes in the defense for him. Then you flip it over to the defensive side. They're proud of their defense too. They display that same toughness, but they show a little speed too, especially in the secondary. The cheetahs, they call the defensive backs, and they'll go get the football, especially Nigel Malone, their corner.
Well, they're gonna have an opportunity to go after the football, because when you look at this Arkansas team, they may be the fastest squad offensively in the nation.
Relay team, anyone? Because that's what they have. When you think about, the wide receivers and what they do, but Tyler Wilson triggers it, as the guys talked about in the pregame show. He'll throw to all those different people. But when you look at Arkansas, they also show that element of toughness too. Flip it over to defense, interior defense, and their secondary. Jermaine Thomas is a tough player back in the backfield. I can't wait. Let's go ahead and do this, Gus. No more talking about it. Let's go ahead and get to it. This stadium is electric. It's alive. These people are ready to go and see some football. Number 6, Arkansas. Number 8, Kansas State.
The 76th AT&T Cotton Bowl. 80,000 fans. A sellout crowd in attendance. In the house that Jerry built. As the Kansas State Wildcats prepare to come on to the field. The Arkansas Razorbacks can be described in many ways. Tough, explosive, and fast are all well earned. Tonight, the Razorbacks look to show everyone they are an elite team and add to a long tradition of excellence. The teams are ready as we get closer to kickoff here at Cowboys Stadium. The head coach of this Kansas State squad, 72 years old, Bill Snyder, in his 20th season. He's been named the 2011 National Coach of the Year by 4 publications, named the AP Big 12 Coach of the Year as well. And on the other sideline, 50-year-old Bobby Petrino. What a year he's had. He's led this team to back-to-back 10-win seasons for just the 3rd time in school history. His only losses of the season at Alabama and at LSU, the top 2 teams in the nation. The Razorbacks won the toss. They've elected to receive and a very dangerous team when it comes to their special teams. Arkansas, they have 5 kick return touchdowns this season, 3 punts and 2 kickoffs, the most in college football. As you take a look at the series note between these two teams, it dates back to 1910. They haven't played in 44 years. K-State leading the series 3-1. Their last meeting at 67. Arkansas winning 28-7. So Anthony Cantelli will send it away. And back deep, Dennis Johnson and Marquell Wade. K-State, Arkansas, and we're underway. Line drive kick fielded at the 25-yard line, and getting outside is Morgan Linton down the sideline, and Arkansas will start at the K-State 40. So let's take a look at the starting lineups for this Arkansas offense. Very dangerous, chock full of speed.
And second team All-SEC performer Alvin Bailey helps anchor the offensive line. He's a terrific player, 25 starts in just 2 short seasons. And when they want to throw the ball, they have that track team. But keep an eye on their tight end, number 80, Chris Gregg, a former wide receiver. He's bulked up to play tight end. He'll be quite a threat this evening.
Tyler Wilson, first team All-SEC, the first Arkansas quarterback to be named All-Conference since Quinn Grovey in 1988 when they were in the Southwest Conference. And on first down, incomplete. Ball intended for Joe Adams, defensively for K-State.
Ray Kibble is their stout run defender on the interior. The defensive tackle had his best season as a Wildcat, rewarded first team All-Conference. At linebacker, the transfer from Miami, Arthur Brown, anchors things. He's also a first-team All-Big 12 performer. And back deep, David Garrett may be small, but he makes plenty of plays.
Second down and 10 of the 42. Dennis Johnson, the lone setback for Tyler Wilson. This Arkansas offense averaging 446 yards per game. And they hand it Johnson with running room over the right side. And he'll get inside the 40-yard line, and it's a gain of about 6. Rafael Guidry with the tackle along with Ray Kibble.
And it's the type of game that Arkansas needed on 2nd and 10 to put them in this 3rd and what everyone likes to call manageable. 3rd or 4 or less is what offensive play callers are looking for.
3rd down and 4. With time, over the middle, knocked away, beautifully done, Ty Zimmerman. The sophomore from Junction City, Kansas, reaching around.
Tyson Hartman in the secondary with Ty Zimmerman. They're 2 great secondary players. Zimmerman, number 12 on the coverage, comes up and goes over the top. Gregg appeared to slip a little bit on his route, but a nice play by Zimmerman. Over the top, no pass interference.
So look at this. They're going for it. 4th down and 4 at the 36, opening drive for the Razorbacks.
And the player he trusts is Jarius Wright, number 4, 3rd man in on the slot.
Tyler Wilson in the shotgun. And he'll throw it again. Wilson with all day steps up in the pocket. Shovels it off to Dennis Johnson, but he won't get there, or will he? Let's see where they spot the football. Looks like they will be short. Arkansas going for it on 4th down. Coach Petrino not happy.
Well, why did the play become successful? Look at the coverage in the secondary. There's nowhere to go with the football. Everyone is swallowed up, and that allows Jordan Volker now to get into the pass rush. There he is at the end. He shovels it off, but it's too late. Excellent job by the Kansas State secondary.
So K-State takes over at their own 36. Colin Klein, one of the great rushing quarterbacks of this season, under center. John Hubert, the deep man. Play action, Klein rolling, throws sideline, and it's got man at midfield. That's Tremaine Thompson, with the reception, and it's a gain of 13 yards. Let's take a look at the lineup for Kansas State.
And they're anchored by a freshman, B.J. Finney. He's got some freshman All-American mention for his play this season. And then when they do want to throw the ball, their number one threat is Chris Harper, number three, a former quarterback turned wide receiver. He's really blossomed this season.
So a surprise. K-State coming out, chucking it on first down. Now at their own 49. Out of the eye. Delayed handoff. Hubert. And he's stacked up. Pyle pushed forward. He'll gain a couple to Narius Wright with the tackle. Defensively, let's take a look at Arkansas.
Jake Beckett, their all SEC defensive end, anchors things. 21 and a half sacks in his career. In the middle, Jerry Franklin has led the Arkansas team in tackles for four straight seasons. And back deep, their leading tackler over the last four ball games has been Tremaine Thomas. He's been awfully active in the secondary, making plays on the football.
Second down and seven at the 48-yard line. 6:43 to play, first half, 76th AT&T Cotton Bowl. From the house that Jerry built, what a facility, folks. Cowboys Stadium, Klein looking, flag on the play. Klein elects to run and gets to the 40. But a flag in the backfield. Brian Jones makes the tackle. Excuse me, Byron Jones.
Look at the coverage downfield that Arkansas provides.
Holding offense to the 75. 10 yards from the previous spot. Still second down.
All receivers covered up. Look at this. Everyone, even when a receiver runs it past one guy, the other guy picks him up. So that led to this, the hold by Clyde Offner, number 75, on Tenarius Tank Wright.
So far, two teams that look very well matched. Two teams that lost only two games the entire season. Second down and 33. Clyde sacked. He lost it. Arkansas may have the football, and they do. Jake Beckett with the sack, his ninth of the year.
So take a look here. Jake Beckett out wide working against Zach Hansen. It was second team all Big 12, and he goes right by him and doesn't just sack him, but knocks the ball free, separates it. And Tenarius Tank Wright, his counterpart at the opposite defensive end, comes up with the football. Great field position for Arkansas now. The first big mistake of the game goes against the Kansas State Wildcats, and that's not normal for them. Look out for a big shot early here from Arkansas.
Beckett, first team all SEC. Now Arkansas with the football at the 13. Johnson running it. And Johnson will get past the line of scrimmage. Possibly 2 yards on the play. Williams coming up with the tackle. Kansas State, they've turned the ball over, Charles, just 13 times in 12 games. Seventh best in college football. And they were plus 13 in turnover margin.
And look at how Arkansas has jumped out tonight. They have 9 straight games with a takeaway, trying to combat what Kansas State does so well.
Second down and 8 at the 11-yard line. Defense, a big story in this game thus far. Arkansas, the more explosive team, with their best field position of the night. Draw play. Johnson again trying to jitterbug. And Johnson knocked backwards. Ball should be spotted around the 10-yard line. And the Razorbacks ranked second in the SEC and 26th in all of college football in red zone success, scoring 87% of the time.
And what they need here is touchdown. Because when you play Kansas State, if you let them hang around and only kick field goals, that plays into their type of game. You've got to set the pace against the Kansas State Wildcats. Otherwise, they chew up clock on you and keep the ball away from you.
Third down and 7 at the 10. Wilson with time. Over the middle, knocked away. Ty Zimmerman. Beautiful job once again. And the Razorbacks will be forced to settle for a field goal.
We talked about the toughness of this Kansas State team at the top, and it's exhibited in many ways. Watch Ty Zimmerman at safety, working against Chris Gregg. Sees the cut, breaks on the football,
goes inside and knocks it away. A second knockdown for Ty Zimmerman in this young ball game.
So Zach Hocker on the season, 18 of 24. His long 50 from 26 yards away, up and good. So the Razorbacks score first, 3-0, 4:19 to play. A lot of hitting and tough defense going on here at the AT&T Cotton Bowl. Back after this. The Razorbacks are 3-7-1 in the Cotton Bowl. Their last appearance in 2008, a 38-7 loss to Missouri. Jermaine Thompson, Chris Harper, ready to receive the football for K-State. And it's fielded at the 5-yard line by Thompson. And Thompson weaving his way, and he'll go down. So Kansas State will start inside their own 5, but I like the energy of this game so far. Reminds you of that LSU-Alabama game. Great defense, and that's what we're seeing right now. These two teams are really playing hard.
And what you're looking for now is which team can get a couple of explosive plays and put them together to create yardage and open up some space against the defensive front.
From the 3, first down, Huber. And he'll be lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage. Isaac Madison, first man to him, another Arkansas helmet flying. And that takes us to the end of the first quarter with the score, the Razorbacks 3, the Wildcats 0. Second quarter coming up, Big D. And welcome back to the AT&T Cotton Bowl Classic as we start the second quarter. Gus Johnson, Charles Davis, Tim Brewster, and Darryl Johnston. And folks, we've got a good old-fashioned defensive ball game brewing for Kansas State. 13 plays, 24 yards for Arkansas. 13 plays, 37 yards. These teams average 800 yards between them. Klein in the gun. Klein going up the sideline. Incomplete. Chris Harper, the intended receiver. And that brings up third and long.
I like what they did, though, because they faked the bread and butter play, which is Colin Klein on a running play, run a little stop and go action. But Isaac Madison, number 6, does a really nice job of not being fooled by Chris Harper slowing down and then accelerating, stays right with him, and is on the spot.
Third down, 9, after 4 for Klein. In the shotgun out of his own end zone. Huber right next to him. Klein flushed out. Throws on the run. Incomplete. Intended for Harper again. Looks like that may have gone through his hands. If so, his second drop of the game.
Should have run the football. This is one time where Colin Klein was a little bit too unselfish. Watch as he flushes from the pocket and then take a look. Look at this. That's usually his territory to run the football. I understand he had a guy down there, but that's a tougher throw. Let the big fella run it and try and pick it up.
Door in the back of his own end zone punting this football. And he gets it away. Wade and Adams back deep. Adams with it at the 45. Adams skipping. Adams gets outside. Watch out. Hits the sideline. The Jet. Touchdown, Arkansas.
Okay, watch when Joe Adams catches the football, because they tell you as a punt returner, you need to make the first man miss, but it also helps when you get an initial block. Okay, there's the first block. Now watch, right there. That allowed him to get to the sideline where the fence was formed. And once he gets to the sideline, it's over.
What an electric move by Joe Adams. His best game of the year versus Missouri State. He had 2 punt returns for touchdowns. his fourth return for a touchdown of the season, and Arkansas takes a 10-0 lead. Back after this. 10-0, Arkansas with the lead now. What a return by Joe Adams, and he got some help from his friends.
Did he ever, because he sets it up perfectly, but watch coming to the, right there. That's Ross Rasner, 35. Terrific block. He's a backup linebacker, but he gets some more help. Watch Jericho Nelson, 31, right there. A second block, another block here, and then once he gets to the corner, look out. That was Tevin Mitchell, number 8, with the other block. And that's when the jet propels.
And this is where Arkansas wanted to be. Coach Petrino telling us they wanted to play from the front and make this Kansas State squad chase them. Thompson and Harper back deep. And K-State will take a knee. Well, it's been a long time, folks. Let's go back to 1961. The Arkansas Razorbacks' Lance Allworth returned a punt 49 yards against Duke in the 1961 Cotton Bowl. That was the last time a punt was returned for a touchdown in this classic game.
Fitting that it was an Arkansas player, the man later known as Bambi in the NFL, Lance Allworth. So we look at this, their 8th special teams and defensive return touchdown this season for Arkansas. And that's the first one given up on special teams this year for Kansas State. And we just noted Lance Allworth there. But Arkansas, a proud tradition of excellent punt returners, including Ken Hatfield, their former head coach.
First down and 10 at the 20-yard line. For Klein. And Klein elects to keep it, and he is dragged down. Terrific job by Zach Stadler as he read the play perfectly and dropped him for a loss.
You know what they say about Zach Stadler? Not a great technique player, but somehow it turns out right for him. He's one of those guys that you don't worry about the technique, you don't worry about his hand placement, but somehow he finds his way to the football, having a fine season this year as a senior.
Angelo Peace in the Wildcat. He looks to throw it. And Peace steps up and goes down. Great pursuit, Alonzo Highsmith, the junior from Missouri City, Texas, with the tackle.
What I don't understand here is Kansas State taking the ball out of Colin Klein's hands and putting it in someone else's hands when they're down 10-0. 10-0 is not insurmountable by any stretch, but I think they've got to get their quarterback going. And the run game is what's been their bread and butter all year long. Get back to doing what you do best and let Colin Klein have his opportunities.
Third down and 13 at the 17-yard line. Four receivers at the bottom of your screen. Klein over the middle and drop. Wow. Broderick Smith, and it's been that kind of first half for Kansas State. Drop passes, penalties. They've hurt themselves.
Coming from the left side of your screen will be Broderick Smith crossing in the zone, and that's a nice throw by Colin Klein. When your team's down 10-0, you've got to help out. Now, Broderick Smith missed a lot of this season. Bill Snyder didn't play him, never really announced why. His first game action from about midseason was in their last game against Iowa State.
Listed as a starter, but only has 6 catches for 60 yards on the whole season. And Dorr sends it away. Adams with the fair catch at the 46 and 37-yard line. The Razorbacks with excellent field position. Coming up, we'll see if they can move it against the Cats.
Excellent field position for Arkansas as we start here. The pressure shifts to Kansas State's defense right now. The offense is struggling. Bobby Petrino is a play caller. It's cold-blooded. He's looking for some of those explosive plays, the 25-yard passes, the 15-yard runs with this series.
First down at their own 46 for Tyler Wilson. And the Arkansas offense, Dennis Johnson with a huge hole, still on his feet at the 30 and down. At the Kansas State 25, Nigel Malone making the tackle, but it's a gain of 28.
One of the explosives we talked about, look at the left side of the line and watch how well blocked this play is. Look at the hole. He's to the third level, to the secondary, before you can blink. Runs through a tackle by Ty Zimmerman, number 12. Tyson Hartman can't bring him down. And he's off to a big, big play.
First down and goal to the 8-yard line. A gain of 8 and gain of 9 on the last two plays. Wingo in the backfield with Tyler Wilson. Here's Wingo. Low to the ground, and he goes forward, but Vi Latui is there for the tackle.
I'll be surprised if they throw the, if they run the football anymore on this series. Second and goal, hard to run it against them, even though they got the explosive run. I think they're going to put it in Tyler Wilson's hands. Jarius Wright, you just mentioned it. We haven't called his name yet. Third from the top, inside.
Second down and goal to the 7. And Wilson wants to run it. And he gets down to the 2-yard line. The outside linebacker makes the saving tackle.
And I don't think that was a called quarterback draw. I think he just saw the gap and flushed and went to it. Remember in our meetings with him, he said one of the things he thought he could improve on was actually using that mobility and running the ball more when he felt pressure in his face.
Third down and goal of the 2. Arkansas, 1 of 5 on third down conversions. Wingo, the single setback. Wingo running right, and he's stopped. What a job by that Kansas State defense safety, Tyson Hartman, making the play. And it's a loss of 3.
One of the top student athletes in the nation is number 2, Tyson Hartman. Look how he stays stout, stays square to the line, and slips the block of Jarius Wright. The National Football Foundation gave him an $18,000 postgraduate scholarship. But he's not done playing football and smacking people just yet.
So Hawker comes in to attempt a 22-yard field goal. And good. 9:20 to go, second quarter, as Arkansas takes a 13-0 lead. So Jermaine Thompson will let it go out of the end zone. K-State will have it at the 20. And Kansas State has 22 yards of offense, 23 yards in penalties.
And look at what they've done for, based on their season so far. Time of possession way down from what they normally do. -1 after being +13 in turnover margin. But credit their defense. They've held them to 2 field goals and scoring opportunities and have kept them in the game.
First down at the 20-yard line. And the Wildcats will run it as Wilson, the fullback, carrying for the 2nd time, stopped by Robert Thomas.
And they also had Colton Miles Nash, number 90. Bottom of your screen at defensive end. He's been a tight end for most of the year. They flipped him over to defensive end. Watch him also stay home. Initial contact. Well played.
Second down, 8 at the 22. Clyde runs a football and is lucky to get back to the line of scrimmage as Ross Rasner, we've been mentioning his name quite a bit tonight, comes up with a tackle.
Coach Brewster did a nice job talking about Arkansas winning on first down on defense, where they're setting up second and long, and then it's turning into second long to third and long. The new defensive coordinator, Paul Haynes, has a new spirit on this team. They've held this rushing team to 11 yards tonight. They average close to 200 per game.
Third down, 8 of the 22. They need to go to the 30 for first down. Wilson, the motion man. Klein looks backside, sets up a screen. Hubert, and another terrific defensive play by this Arkansas squad. Tevin Mitchell, the freshman from Mansfield, Texas, makes the tackle in space.
You talk about staying home. Watch to the bottom of your screen, number 8, Tevin Mitchell. Watch what he does. Flow goes away. He stays behind, sees him set it up, slips the block inside by number 50, Nick Pitts, and makes the play on Hubert.
fifth punt for Doar. Adams will get a shot from the 31. And Adams gets to the 39, a 52-yard punt and a 9-yard return. So with the score 13-0, coming up, the K-State defense trying to keep this team in the game. 7 minutes to play in the second quarter. 13-0. Arkansas with the lead and the football as they start at their own 39. And Bob Petrino has made some sweeping changes with this team. And one of them starting to play dividends already as they pitch it to Adams. And Adams tries to turn the corner. Drop around the line of scrimmage by Arthur Brown. So some new coaches on this Arkansas squad, Charles.
And you're talking about sweeping changes paying dividends. Talk about Paul Haynes, the defensive coordinator, who has the Arkansas defense playing so well. That's him in the box making calls, but he's doing it in the lingo of Arkansas. He doesn't have his new stuff in. Reggie Johnson, who was right next to him, he's the linebacker's coach. So if he gets stuck with a call, Reggie puts it into Arkansas language for him.
They throw it far side, and Childs breaks a tackle. So defensive coordinator Will Robinson moved on. Paul Haynes, who spent the last 7 years in Ohio State and coached with Petrino in the NFL with the Jacksonville Jaguars, was named the defensive coordinator. Offensive coordinator Garrett McGee was named the coach at Alabama Birmingham. Paul Petrino's brother, Bobby Petrino's brother Paul, rather, comes back after spending 2 seasons at Illinois. So two coordinators out, two coordinators in at Arkansas. 3rd and 6 to 43. Wilson stepping up with a lane. And he gets inside Kansas State territory down to the 42. Nigel Malone tripping him up. It's a 14-yard gain.
And one of the things that goes along with Tyler Wilson with his toughness is his imagination now. Watch it come out. He told us in our meeting, I have to do a better job of using my legs when the opportunity presents itself. So far tonight, he's doing an excellent job of that. Open lane, he finds it and runs tough for a first down. And plenty of effort. And so far, the Arkansas defense is giving him exactly that.
First down and 10 at the 43. Wilson scrambling, dumps it off. Johnson in the flats. But an interesting question, Charles. You finish your season at Arkansas 10-2. Your only losses come to the two best teams in the nation, LSU and Alabama. And you fire your defensive coordinator.
He knew that wasn't the direction he wanted to continue to go. And he knew that with a month's time, and recruiting, he wanted a new coach in place to start moving forward towards 2012.
Second down and 8 at the 41. Wilson hands it off to Johnson. And Johnson trying to hurdle, but nothing doing. David Garrett took on a block and made the play, a loss of 4. This Kansas State defense, they're keeping this team in the game.
Without a doubt. And David Garrett, who last year played a lot of linebacker, despite being 5'9", 175, his teammates call him Rat. Textbook tackle. Takes down Dennis Johnson.
Third down and 12 of the 45. Ronnie Wingo back in the game. Tyler Wilson going for the home run. Wilson, touchdown. Darius Wright, 45 yards. His first catch of the game. Jarius Wright's name, one of the most prolific receivers in all of college football. He remained patient. Oh, and the extra point block picked up. Malone for 2. Malone. Kansas State gets on the board the hard way. Another blocked kick.
That's Raphael Guidry, That would be his fifth block of the season. He blocked two field goals against Texas Tech. Watch coming up the middle, 94. Look at him, shoots the gap. As he says, makes himself skinny, makes himself small, and gets by and envelops it. He had never, school record four block kicks in the season. He had never blocked a kick in three previous seasons at Kansas State. Only nine tackles for the year, but how about this value? That was his fifth on the season, and it gains his team points. And boy, a team that was struggling, that gives them a new life.
Huge play, giving this Kansas State squad a little bit of momentum. Not only does this Kansas State squad finally get on the board with 4:10 remaining in the second quarter, they get the football back as well with the chance to put more points on the board. Jermaine Thompson, Chris Harper are back deep.
Without a doubt, the defensive side of the football, despite being down 19-2, has been what's kept Kansas State going in this game. This could be worse. Remember, two opportunities they held the field goals.
Razorback send it away. Out of the end zone once again. Zach Hockett has been drilling the football tonight.
I think they're playing a little Tampa 2 here, because watch Arthur Brown. He's going to end up running down the pipe in the middle of the field trying to run with Jarius Wright. Ty Zimmerman, number 12, is a safety back deep. And look at this. With that matchup, Jarius Wright on Arthur Brown, Tyler Wilson identifies and goes to the right man for the touchdown.
Jarius Wright, first team All-SEC. What a game he had right here against Texas A&M. 13 catches, 281 yards, and two touchdowns.
One of those was a heads-up play off of a fumble that he fell on a ball in the end zone to preserve the touchdown.
So let's see if Colin Klein can get the offense going. Klein winds up, throws, nice catch. Sheldon Smith hauling it in, first down for the Cats.
And this is not supposed to be a strength of Colin Klein's, and I mean throwing the football. But now he has to turn it into one. Under 4 minutes to go, they could use some points and extra momentum going into the half after the extra point block and score.
Klein 3 for 8, 22 yards. Klein looking, and Klein wants to run it again, and this time is gobbled up. Byron Jones, a sophomore from Junction City, Arkansas, making the tackle. And don't forget, folks, coming up at halftime is the Pizza Hut halftime show with Kevin Frazier, Marcus Allen, and Daryl Johnston. We'll have first half highlights, opinions, and analysis, and performances by both bands. Second down and 12 to 42. Remember, Allen and Johnston predicted that Kansas State would win this game. Hubert out of bounds. It'll be interesting to see their comments after one half of play, which has been a very sloppy first half, unfortunately, for the Wildcats.
Which is very uncharacteristic for them, because they're usually the ones that force the other team into sloppy play. But how about the tackling by Arkansas? We talked about Paul Haynes. One of the things that attracted Bob Petrino to him, how well his secondary tackled at Ohio State. It's carrying over tonight to Arkansas.
Third down, 6 at the 48. Klein pumping and dumps it incomplete. Kansas State with a decision to make now on 4th and 6 with 1:40 to go, and they will make the best decision possible and punt it away with Ryan Doerr.
Most prudent. Get rid of the football. Make them go the long field. Don't turn it over to him here at midfield, especially as quick strike as Arkansas is. Although punting to Joe Adams, that could be fraught with disaster too.
Ryan Doerr is 6th punt, standing at the 34. Spiraling kick over the head of Adams, takes a bounce and will be down inside the 15. A 39-yard punt. Nicely done by Ryan Doerr.
Oftentimes in this situation, backed up, you run some type of a draw or a screen, and if you get decent yardage, you may start your offense.
Third down and 6. Wilson in trouble, lost it! And can't State says they have it, and they do. What a play. Adam Davis recovers it.
Watch Wilson in the pocket, and the pressure comes inside. Really well played there, because number 97, Adam Davis, spins him down and knocks the ball free. And when the ball's knocked free, that's when Kansas State rallies to the football, wins the battle below. Adam Davis, another big play. Remember the big tackle earlier on third and short? This time he knocks it free and gives Kansas State an opportunity before the half ends. Of course, recovered by number 40, Ryan Mueller.
First down and 10 at the 12. Golden opportunity for K-State. No timeouts. Klein running. And they're going to have to get to the line of scrimmage quickly. Under a minute to go for Coach Snyder. So what's the strategy here? You have no timeouts. Worst case scenario, you want 3 points.
You want three. Worst case scenario, that would be a win for Arkansas. Colin Klein, any type of run pass option, you might see it here.
Second down and 9. Klein steps up in the pocket. Klein trying to make something happen. At the 5, goes down at the 2. 30 seconds to go. A first down. The clock will stop until the ball's reset. And that gives Kansas State a chance to get to the line of scrimmage. Kubert in the backfield. Klein rolls out of the pocket. Klein looks backside wide open. Touchdown! Andre McDonald, the tight end. And Kansas State back in business.
What a nice call by Bill Snyder and his offensive staff. Here's McDonald, 18. He's going to go through the traffic here because the motion goes away. So instead of the power run to pick up the first down, they go sprint right, throw back motion to the left side, and McDonald's wide open for the touchdown.
So with 25 seconds remaining in the first half after a sluggish start, Kansas State with an opportunity. Arkansas got out front quickly, but Kansas State got a couple of good bounces and reeled them in. 19-9, our halftime score. Kansas State will have the ball to start the second half. We'll be back with a Pizza Hut halftime show with Kevin Frazier, Marcus Allen, Moose, right here in Dallas after these messages from your local Fox station. Welcome back to the 76th AT&T Cotton Bowl. Two top 10 teams battling, Kansas State and Arkansas. 19-9, our score as we prepare to start the third quarter. Gus Johnson, along with Charles Davis, CD. Very interesting first half for a number of reasons.
Yeah, indeed, because it was hard to get a flow going, especially for Kansas State. They hurt themselves in the first half. But the other part of it is Arkansas has limited them in a big way, yet they're in a fight. You would think Arkansas would be up with a shutout, but the reason they weren't is because they gave up stuff late in the first half.
All right, that brings us to the Ford first half statistics.
And this is what throws you right here. 60 total yards on 31 offensive plays for Kansas State. They're down in every category, yet they're right there in the game. Credit their defense in the first half, where they limited Arkansas to 2 field goals and touchdown scoring situations. The blocked point after touchdown for 2 points. They hung in there tough, and they've given their team an opportunity.
So we start the second half. Kansas State, who deferred in the first half, will get the football. We will see if they can continue to build on that late second quarter momentum, which started with the blocked extra point, and the result was 2 points. Their first points of the game. So Tremaine Thompson and Chris Harper back deep. Zach Hocker will tee it up. And the second half underway. A line drive kick that may go out of bounds, and does. So now Kansas State will get the football at the 40.
Kicking team. Ball be placed first and 10 at the 40-yard line. Kansas State.
Let's go downstairs to Coach Tim Brewster.
Thank you, Gus. And talking to Bobby Petrino at the half, he said that they cannot turn the ball over. Huge emphasis in the game. They must continue to play great first down defense. For Kansas State, too many third and longs. They've only got 60 total yards. Colin Klein's going to have to run for some yards, and those receivers are going to have to make some plays for him.
All right. Thank you very much, Coach. The first half, especially in the first quarter, Kansas State completely out of sync. They look like the team that hadn't had a chance to play in a game in a month. Penalties, drop passes. But now, let's see where they start here at the 40. Hubert in the backfield, play action. Klein rolling out, dumps it off. Nice catch, Tannehill to get out of bounds. As he crosses the 45 to the 46, Jericho Nelson with the tackle.
Coach Brewster outlined the terrific first down defense that Arkansas played in the first half. But the last taste in the Arkansas defense's mouth, a touchdown against them going into the half. Then their kicker kicks it out of bounds to start the second half, and Kansas State with a nice first down play. The momentum swinging Kansas State's way.
Second down and four. Colin Klein completing his first pass of the second half. This time he decides to run it and picks up a first down and more. As he crosses midfield, gets inside Arkansas territory for game nine.
This is just like a tailback lead if he's a running back. Watch Hubert lead him into the hole, but watch the patience of Colin Klein. Waits for the blocks to form, sees it, sifts his way through. A little extra power at the end for another first down for Kansas State.
From the 45. Wilson and Hubert. And the offset eye behind Klein. Play clock winding down. They get it off. Option. Here's the pitch. Hubert trying to break it back. Great pursuit by Arkansas. Leading the way to Tanarius Wright. That's a loss of seven.
And coaches on both sides of the ball always talk about winning first down. This is a huge win on first down for Arkansas because the play's made back here. Because no one goes so far away that when he has to reverse field, that they're not home. They're back at home. Excellent job. Anytime you play option football, you have to be what is called gap sound. All gaps were covered by Arkansas's defense.
Second and 17. Klein looking to the sideline. Fires. Blocked. Beautiful throw and beautiful catch. Tremaine Thompson. A gain of 21. First down. K-State.
Let's go back to the first series of the game. And Tremaine Thompson dropped one that he probably should have had. We start the first series of the second half, and he flips the script and turns all the way around and comes up with one that's a difficult catch.
K-State looks locked and loaded now. First down at the 31. Hubert with room, spinning, and goes down to the Arkansas 20. And he's close to a first down. Eric Bennett makes the tackle.
This Kansas State team, and we don't know how this drive will ultimately end. But every team that ever plays Kansas State that gets a lead has all regretted not putting them away when they had an opportunity. This Kansas State team is like zombies. You can do what you want, but you cannot kill this team off.
First down at the 21. Klein runs it over the right side. Squares his shoulders. Klein gets out of bounds at the 6. Jerry Franklin ushers him out of bounds. But right now, this Kansas State team starts the second half with great rhythm.
Watch the zone read by Colin Klein. Sees it, and he gets two pullers coming at him. You see Offner 75 out there leading. Really well done, and he runs through a tackle by Eric Bennett and holds the football.
Opening drive of the second half for Kansas State, which began at their own 40. After Arkansas kicked the opening kickoff out of bounds. Klein again. Touchdown, Cats. And they're popping their collars now. K-State right back in this game.
this is just simply going to be quarterback power because he's going to fake it in front. Now watch. He just follows Hubert right there. There's a block, and then he steps through with a nice little jump cut in the end where he jumps from one side to the other to make a tackle or miss to get into the end zone.
Extra point up and good. Record tie touchdown for Colin Klein. But more importantly, 1916. We've got a ball game in Big D. Now 1916 as Kansas State scores on their opening drive of the second half. Colin Klein ties Ricky Williams with another touchdown, 27th this season.
And also the national quarterback record set by Ricky Dobbs of Navy. Remember, Ricky Williams didn't get bowl game benefit in his touchdown numbers. He had two in his bowl game.
Here's Wayne returning it from the 10. And he loses an edge and gets down at the 25. Let's go downstairs to our Daryl Johnson with an injury update.
Thank you, guys. Well, no new information on Meshack Williams. As soon as we find out some news, we will immediately update you. But I agree with you right now, Charles. This is one of those games that's turning into Kansas State's favor right now. And who would have thought that that block kick by Raphael Guidry and the scoop and score by Nigel Malone would turn the tide the way it has?
And right now, we have to find out Arkansas's toughness, which they have to display because Kansas State has matched them now.
First down to the 25. Ball caught by Jarius Wright, a second catch of the game, a flag on the play. As Wright gets up to the 35 before being ridden down.
Think they got a little cage. Watch the tackle by Chapman 3. See right there? Hand on the face mask. That's for the flag.
Face mask. Defense number 27. 15 yards from the end of the run. Automatic first down.
It's actually number 3, Alan Chapman, who made the play. They hung it on David Garrett, but number 3, Alan Chapman. Nonetheless, the penalty goes for Arkansas to give them a little extra breathing room and an excellent field position out near midfield.
Chapman, a junior from San Francisco. First down and 10 of the 42 for Arkansas. Wilson, play fake with time, delivers. Oh, what a great catch by his tight end, Chris Gregg. Thrown in front of him, and the big fella with great hands and balance.
We've been waiting for this all night. A little bit more of Chris Gregg. They actually made some plays on the football when he was the primary receiver in the first half. And I was at practice on Tuesday. Nice throw, but if he keeps him on his feet, he's still running.
First catch. Now Adams outside, and he'll gain 7.5, maybe 8, as David Garrett pushes him out of bounds.
Gus, we talked about Gregg at the top of the show, that there would be more opportunities for him, the third leading receiver for Arkansas. I was at practice on Tuesday, and he ran a route that brought him open. And as they got to the sideline, Jarius Wright told him, we're going to get you open on game night because they're going to be looking at us a lot. Be prepared. He was on the last catch.
Second down and 2, his quarterback also praising his tight end, saying that he's one of the most reliable receivers on this team. Green running the football. Broderick Green stopped by Trey Walker, the outside linebacker. Broderick Green, bruising running back, 6'2", 244.
Trey Walker standing up, watches flow, shoots the gap. And you talk about bruising. It takes a lot to get Broderick Green down. He's a good, tough, short yardage runner, transfer from USC, who battled back from a knee injury in the spring, ACL surgery. They didn't expect to have him all season long. And he returned in time for the Texas A&M game in the regular season.
Came into this game with 216 yards rushing on 61 carries. Wilson over the middle, finds a man. It's Adams, and he's bumped and taken down. Great job by Lemur. Emmanuel Lemur, the senior from West Palm Beach, Florida, junior college transfer. Well, that makes it second down and 12 of the 24. As Childs goes to the top of your screen, along with Wright and Adams. Empty backfield. Wilson fires in the corner. Incomplete. Greg almost had it. Bobbled it at the end. But what an effort.
See Greg leaning back, trying to possess it as he goes down, unable to complete the catch. Had it in the end zone, unable to haul it in. Tyler Wilson bought a little extra time in the pocket with some deft footwork in order to get the ball downfield to the end zone.
So a big third down at 12 of the 22. Wilson over the middle. Caught. Childs. First down, Arkansas. A money throw on third down at 12.
Watch Tyler Wilson in the pocket. Watch as he looks to the right. Okay, see the vision? He's looking there. Then he comes back to the left side. Why does he look right? To move the defenders in that direction and create a throwing lane back to the left for the completion for the first down.
Wilson, 13 of 21, 124 yards and a touchdown. No picks. First down and goal at the 9. The handoff to Green. And he'll get inside the 5. Kansas State in the red zone has been bent but don't break as Hartman is down. And that could be a huge loss for the Cats.
And look at this. 7 rushes, 1 pass in the red zone, only 2 field goals. I think they have to reverse that, and I think it starts here on this down.
Roderick Green remains in the game. On 2nd and goal at the 4. Play action. In the end zone! Out of bounds. Kobe Hamilton couldn't get a foot in.
And in a sense, Tyler Wilson missed the layup because he was so wide open. He needs to just go ahead and stop the receiver in the back of the end zone and put it right on him. He threw it a little bit high, and watch, the momentum takes his receiver over the back line.
So with Hartman on the sideline, let's see if they go after the safety again. Matthew Pearson. Empty backfield. Wilson over the middle. Caught. Hamilton, touchdown, Razorbacks. Fourth receiving touchdown of the year for Kobe Hamilton.
Wilson again in the pocket, looking, finds his guy, and delivers the strike. And the toughness question about Arkansas, answering the big challenge that Kansas State has put on them with a touchdown.
Zach Hocker coming in. Extra point is good. 3:57 to play in the 3rd. And the Razorbacks take a 26-16 lead. So Arkansas responding. Kansas State, we will see. As Tremaine Thompson takes the knee, and the Cats will get it at the 20. First down at the 20 for K-State. Klein pulls it back. Klein looking to the sideline. And a catch is made. Tremaine Thompson cradling it and gains 23.
You know what I like about this throw? You'll see the route by Thompson, 86, because he's going to come across the field. But what happens with the throw, he doesn't take him over the sideline. He stops him and gives him an opportunity to go down, slide, and catch the football. A lot of people look at it as that's not a great-looking throw. It's the right throw. If he keeps it in the air, he takes him over the sideline, and it's likely incomplete.
First down. Klein handing it off this time to Hubert, and he slices his way. Close to a first down. Gains 8. Jericho Nelson makes the tackle.
This is a quarterback power play, because watch, he's going to ride his, he's going to ride the running back as he fakes it to Hubert. See, he stays with him, and because the defensive end widens out, he's able to stick it in his belly and take it inside for a nice run upfield. Good read by Colin Klein and John Hubert.
Second down and short. They need 2 yards at the 34. Kansas State having no problems moving the football. Klein drops back, steps up, and is chopped down. Great job. Second sack of the night for Jake Beckett. And he has been hell-bent to get to the quarterback.
And last series, he was the one who ended the series with this big hit on Colin Klein. Look at the coverage again. Where does he go with the football? Because that play was the companion play to the last run. The same ride, and then he stepped back to throw it, but Jake Beckett had other ideas and puts him down.
Third down, 5 at the 37. Klein to the shotgun. Klein throws a slant. Caught. Chris Harper. No, they ruled it incomplete. So now Kansas State has to make a decision.
Because once again, probably too far. Well, too far for a field goal. Probably in that punting range where it might be too short. The hard part,
Tell you what, a lot of drop passes by Kansas State tonight.
That's really hurt them. And the hard part for Bill Snyder is, does he want to give the ball to Bobby Petrino with this type of field position? See, even the snapper got the word late in running on the field, number 46.
Door. They skip it to him. He picks it up. Nicely done by Ryan Door. And he'll boot this one out of the end zone. Arkansas get it at the 20, a 17-yard net, but a nice job to handle. They need to get to the 30 for first down. Three receivers at the top. Wilson sets up underneath, caught by Childs. First down, Arkansas. Greg Childs has been wonderful this evening.
Coming back from knee surgery, he was their number one receiver, but didn't recover in time. And Brighton Adams passed him, rounding into form as he finishes out this season, getting his speed back. Runs a nice route. Wilson finds him for the first down.
A 15-yard gain on third and 8. Wilson again running, and this time he's dropped for a sack. That'll be Kibble. Ray Kibble, the senior from Houston, Texas, with the second sack of the season.
And we've given a lot of credit to the coverage tonight for both teams. On that play, that was just good up front rushing. They forced the play so fast, it really wasn't the coverage that did it. It was the front that got to it.
And that'll take us to the end of the third quarter. Fourth quarter coming up, folks. 26-16. Second down at 14. At the 33-yard line for Arkansas. Thank you very much, Moose. And this kid's running like you used to, Green. The big fella. 36-yard gain. Pearson with the tackle.
And how about the blocking here? Kiero Small is going to lead into the hole, but look at the blocking in the line of scrimmage. Everyone is matched up. Look at that. Everyone's got a man. And then the step over on the tackle by Garrett. Broderick Green with a huge explosive run.
All the way down to the Kansas State 35, 46 and counting for the Razorbacks with a 26-16 lead. Green remains in the game and they give it to him. Green all the way down to the 11. Downhill running for the Razorbacks. A gain of 19.
I love play callers without ego. Meaning, same play.
Run!
Bobby Petrino saw that play work to the other side. So instead of having to show everyone just how fancy he is as a play caller, let's just flip it. Opposite side, same call. Likes what his offensive line is giving him now.
Green this time goes right. And Green will get inside the 10. Clock keeps running. As Jordan Velker makes the stop.
And Broderick Green has given him nice running ability right now, but he's being helped by the lead guy. Number 36, Kiero Small, his fullback. Kiero didn't go to college right out of high school. thought he wanted to work for a living, so his dad put him to work in his t-shirt shop. Guess what? I want to go to college, Dad.
That'll learn you. Second down and 7 at the 9. Here's the pitch. Roderick Green stays in bounds. Does not get back to the line of scrimmage. Arthur Brown with the tackle. And this time a Razorback getting up slowly.
But the key on the play, as you noted,
Grant
was,
Cook.
Was right up here. The clock still runs. And watch the play coming at you. Number 72, Grant Cook with the lead block. And then at the end, when the tackle is made, here comes the pile, and they roll onto his ankle as he's trying to get up.
They hand it off. Roderick Green dumped in the backfield by Arthur Brown, who came out of nowhere. Clock keeps running, 3:37. And now a timeout on the field. And it's good. Third field goal of the night for Zach Hocker. And the Razorbacks, with 3:30 remaining in the fourth, take a 29-16 lead. 29-16, Arkansas, 3:30 remaining in the fourth. Mr. Jerry Jones and Coach Broyles.
About that, pupil and coach. Played for him on the 1964 Arkansas National Championship team.
So Arkansas will send it away. Kansas State with Tremaine Thompson and Chris Harper back deep. And they'll bring it out of the end zone. Thompson. Oh, good special teams play. He's down. And that Seth Ambrose making the tackle. Colin Klein back in.
Power run game pretty much eliminated now because of time for Kansas State. Off to make plays with his arm.
Here's Klein looking, and the ball caught on the far side at the 21 and getting up a little shaky. Terrell Miller.
Through the passer, defense number 42, 15 yards from the end of the run. Automatic first down.
These are the plays you just cannot have at this stage of the game if you're Arkansas. Everything's going your way. You get an incomplete pass. Well after the play, the hit by Chris Smith. Not necessary. Costs his team 15, gets the clock stopped for Kansas State, and gives them better field position. Bad play by Chris Smith.
So they move it up. The pass completed to the 37 with 3 minutes to go. Klein underneath, and this is Chris Harper. And Harper close to the first down.
That's a guy I've been waiting to hear his name called for a long time this evening.
Hurry up offense being used by the Cats. First down at the 47. Klein in trouble. Gets out of the pocket, and he'll run it out of bounds and stop the clock at 2:37. What a season it's been for Colin Klein, named the Big 12's top all-purpose player. Second down and 10 at the 47. Klein responsible for 69% of K-State's yards this season running. And he is dragged down from behind by Alonzo Highsmith. Highsmith has had a great game as well.
That's when you know you're starting to add a few to the odometer. Played against his father in the Sugar Bowl, January of 1986. Oh boy.
Third down and 7 at midfield for Klein. Over the middle, and it's incomplete. Terrell Miller again, and that'll bring up 4th down. With 1:46 to go, and it looks like Kansas State will go for it.
Yeah, I don't think they have a whole lot of choice on this one. What I can't wait to see is what Arkansas decides to do defensively. Do they rush 3, rush 4, and drop everyone else? They've been bringing 5 on certain downs here, even on this possession. They're not just totally laying back. 3-man front. Let's see what they decide to do.
Well, 4th down and 7. They bring pressure. Klein. Oh, beautiful catch. Miller trying to get out of bounds, but they keep him inbounds. Terrell Miller stopped by Greg Gatson, but he gained 13 yards on 4th and 7.
But the clock stops because of the first down. Now they have to hustle to the line of scrimmage and be ready when it's marked in play. It's already started the clock.
Klein. Oh, from behind. Chris Smith, 5th sack of the night for Arkansas.
Remember how he started this sequence with the roughing the passer call, went to the sideline for a little counseling. Reinserted and tries to make up for it with the sack.
2nd down and 15 at the 42. Klein again. And again, he is taken down in the backfield. 6 sacks tonight by the Razorbacks. Chris Smith again, back-to-back sacks. And this defense should be very proud of the way they played.
And Bobby Petrino has to feel great about his move, bringing in new defense coordinator Paul Haynes. His first game calling defenses for Arkansas. Right now, he's got to feel great as they try and finish off this game.
On 3rd down and 20, Klein trying to get outside, and he does. And the clock will stop with 20 seconds remaining.
Very, very difficult for teams that are heavy run teams that aren't super sophisticated in the pass game. When you have to change gears and all you do is throw it and they pin their ears back and come after you, hard to hold up in that. Offensive lines used to run blocking more than pass blocking. And here come the rushers.
4th down and 16. Colin Klein. And picked off. Jericho Nelson down the sideline. Nelson still running. And Nelson finally stopped at the 13 with 5 seconds to go. A 62-yard return. The Arkansas Razorbacks will end their season with an 11-2 record, and what a season it has been. They will win the 76th AT&T Cotton Bowl and realize that their only 2 losses this season came at the hands of the 2 best teams in college football.
And the last time I remember one conference having 1, 2, and 3 in the slots, and I may be wrong, but I remember the old Big 8 with Nebraska, Oklahoma, and Colorado finishing at 1, 2, 3 in the early 70s. And Arkansas is not going to be voted, I don't believe, one of the top 3 teams when it's all said and done because of Oklahoma State's win. But I think they feel like they are one of the top 3 teams in the country having finished this off.
Tyler Wilson and the Arkansas Razorbacks, Bob Petrino, walks off the field for the final time this year with a 29-16 win over Kansas State. 11 wins this year for Arkansas, ties the school record. Bob Petrino faced Coach Snyder tonight. Coach Snyder his second tour duty with this Kansas State squad. They are in hog heaven here in Texas.
And you know it has to feel good for Arkansas? When they were really challenged tonight, they responded after the big run by Kansas State to draw them close.
And for the post-game ceremony, let's go down to Kevin Frazier.
Gus, thank you so much. It is hog heaven here in Cowboy Stadium. And to present the trophy to the Arkansas Razorbacks, the champions of the Cotton Bowl, the chairman of the Cotton Bowl, Tommy Bain.
Thank you, Kevin. Coach Petrino, on behalf of Mark Kiefer and AT&T and the Cotton Bowl Board, it is our privilege to present you the 2012 Cotton Bowl Trophy. Congratulations.
Hey, give me a hand.
Coach Petrino, you get 11 wins this season, but more importantly, you win the Cotton Bowl. What does this mean for the program?
It's just a great win. The first thing I'd like to do is thank our crowd, thank our fans. Thanks for coming, everybody. We got the greatest fans in America. I thought our team really played well. This is what we wanted to do, was send this senior class out with a win. Our senior class did a lot for us, played extremely hard, has really done a great job for this program. We understand that Garrett Uckman was with us today. We miss you, Garrett. I can't say enough about our football team.
What adjustments did you make for the second half to change the momentum of this game?
Well, offensively, we wanted to come out and hit some of our quick game and run the ball better. I thought our offensive line did a much better job on the line of scrimmage in the second half. Defensively, we didn't change a whole lot. We did a good job on first down. We played really well on defense the entire game.
All right, enjoy this one. Congratulations. For the fourth time, the Arkansas Razorbacks are the champions of the Cotton Bowl. Let's send it over to Coach Brewster.
Thank you, Kevin. I'm here with Jake Beckett, and you played great tonight. You had two sacks, relentless effort all game long. Talk about first down defense and the emphasis on that in tonight's game.
Yeah, our game plan, as you could see, was on first and second down, just stop the run. You know, get them out of those second and medium, second and short opportunities, and really get them in third and long and give us a chance to tee off, which we did that.
As a senior, you go out as a winner, Cotton Bowl champions, 11 wins. What's it mean to you, Jake?
It's so special to be part of one of the best teams in Arkansas history. You know, to get 11 wins, you know, hopefully finish the season in the top five, just means so much for our program. And to win this great bowl game, it's just so special.
Congratulations, Jake. Great job.
Thanks,
Gus, back to you.
All right, thank you very much, Coach Brewster. Arkansas with a 29-16 win to win the Cotton Bowl, and it's truly been a very special year for this football team. They have a special, special coach in Bobby Petrino.
Done a fantastic job getting them to the point now where they were going to compete for SEC titles year in and year out. 5-7 in the first year. He talked about those seniors. Look where they end up, 11 wins as seniors.